Ravens fans, we are here with NFL Network's Master of the Draft, Daniel Jeremiah. Is that your official title there?
Yeah, no, I don't want to go anywhere near that one. There are too many misses floating around out there that'll get brought up.
So the one thing I want to ask you first is about receiver. You know, when we talked here last year, if we were to pull up the tape for that, you talked about building a track team around Lamar Jackson. Well, you nailed it. You know, the Ravens took Hollywood Brown with the first pick. So you've talked about them continuing in that direction. Do you think that's the most likely scenario for them in this year's draft?
Well, I think at some point in time they'll add more speed offensively to mix in. I mean, you've seen it with Kansas City, even having Tyreek Hill, and they double down come and get Mecole Hardman. And so I would not be surprised. I would be maybe a little bit surprised if they did it in the first round, just because of the depth of the receiver class. You can find one of those guys later that can really scoot. So to me, you know, kind of trying to find a theme for this year, you've built an offense that can go out and get you a lead. Now let's build the defense that can play with a lead. And I go back to, even though it's a total opposite style of offense, look at the Colts, the way they were built right here in Indianapolis with explosive offense and then speed defensively, be able to rush the passer, be able to cover, because teams are going to be chasing you with the way you're producing points. So getting guys that can really play the pass both in coverage and rush is going to be big.
So if we're talking about the track team on offense, who are the guys that maybe in that second, third round that could be alluring options for the Ravens at receiver?
Jalen Reagor to me is a fun one out of TCU. I think he'll go on day two, and he's going to run in the 4.3s out here this week. So he's got big time juice. You can use him on some of the fly sweep stuff as well. That'd be a fun tag team there with him and Hollywood. But John Hightower from Boise State is probably going to go in the third round. But he's another one who can return kicks. He's got big-time vertical speed. He's great after the catch. He's another one that's done a lot of the fly sweep stuff as well. So, I mean, this is a long list of guys you can find
yeah,
here.
Yeah, I know you've said it's maybe 20-plus guys that go in the first three rounds at receiver. So let's flip it over to the offense or the defensive side of the ball. Pass rush. Uncertain what happens with Matthew Judon. That could be a spot that maybe in the first round, I know Gross Matos is an option potentially there in the end of the first round. Who do you like on the pass rush department?
Well, I think there's a couple interesting options. You know, we'll see. A.J. Epenesa is a bigger rusher, but you know, the Ravens have had a lot of success with those power rushers off the edge, so he gives you some of that with the versatility to kind of move around if you want him to. Chaisson from LSU is probably the fastball, which I'd like to see them get a little bit more dynamic and explosive coming off the edge. I don't know that he's going to make it all the way down there from LSU. And then after that, to me, you start going, the Ravens love to trade back.
Yeah, right.
Eric's always looking to get extra picks. So to me, in like a trade back scenario, somebody like a Jonathan Greenard from Florida who can really bend and is real athletic off the edge, that could be kind of a cake and eat it too situation where you get some extra picks and still get a good player.
You bring up the trade back scenario. They're sitting at 28 right now. They have 7 picks. Once the comp picks are announced, maybe that's up to 9. Do you think that this, considering the volume of picks, that they could go the other direction? Could they package some and maybe move up in the first round?
Yeah, I mean, I think if you see somebody that you really target, that you really, really want, I just think, they have so much confidence in the way they evaluate, and for good reason. You know, when you look at the roster the way it is, more is better. You know, being able to slide back and get more picks, and then also being able to, spin off some of this year's picks for next year as well.
And then lastly, inside linebacker. I think that's probably the most popular mock to the Ravens, Patrick Queen from LSU and Kenneth Murray from Oklahoma. Do you think both of those guys could be there? Either of them could be there for the Ravens? And if the Ravens were to take them, is that a great kind of plug-and-play starting inside linebacker?
That's what makes sense to me, just because, again, linebackers that can really run and cover. And you're going to be playing with a lead, that's important. And run, cover, and blitz, which you want when you have an offense like they have, to complement it. And both, Queen and Murray fit the bill. I don't think both of them will be there. I almost be surprised if either of them will be there, just because they're so dynamic and they're so explosive. But there's other guys too. Once you get into rounds 2 and 3, there's a kid at Wyoming that's really athletic, Logan Wilson. You look at also Ohio State with Malik Harrison's a really good football player. So they'll have options to get that filled.
Well, DJ, we always appreciate the time, the perspective. Ravens fans, you can watch him on the NFL Network here at the Combine and throughout the next several months leading up to the draft. Thanks so much. Good to catch up.
A great catch up.